Okay, good morning to everybody. I'm Sandro Petruzzi, I'm an engineer from Torino, and I work for the metropolitan city of Torino. First of all, I would like to thank the Provincial Council of Barcelona for inviting the metropolitan city. We have a lot of cooperation in a European project with Provincial Council of Barcelona. We are very happy to be here, and the APE organization, of course, for give us the opportunity to show you some of our experience in this file. Unfortunately, the mayor of the metropolitan city of Turin is involved in the election day, just in this week, next Sunday, the second round. So he's very busy. He couldn't attend this meeting, but I wish I can give you all the information about our city. First of all, I would like to define, to explain what is a metropolitan area or metropolitan city, because as you probably know, it's not the city of Turin, the municipality of Turin, but is a city region, as you have in Barcelona, I understood, and we have the same thing. And this is the first point of my presentation, what is a metropolitan city? And then I will give you some data about metropolitan cities in the world, in Europe and in Italy, explaining why they are so important for a sustainable development of our world. And then an overview of the metropolitan city of Turin, the presentation of our city, our strategic plan that we are defining in this year, and I hope some good practices of our city. First question. A metropolitan area is a region, so it's a region, not a city, consisting of a densely populated urban core, but a less populated surrounding with the sharing of industry, infrastructure, and public service. So we have one more urban area, one or more urban areas, of course, but also small towns, rural areas, mountain areas in our case, because we have the 50% of the territory that is in the Alps, so a particular situation. But all these areas, so different, are socio-economically tied with the urban core. Think to the hospital, university, airports, and other important services. So, metropolitan city in the world. Some data, they host 54, more than half of the population live in metropolitan areas, not in metropolitan city, not in city, in metropolitan areas, but in the 3% of the Earth's surface, this is an important issue, and consume the 80% of the resources. And this is a problem, but they produce the 80% of the world GDP, and 85% of the innovation. And this is the solution of the problem of the first slide, of the first image, probably. For this reason, Europe is the most urbanized continent in the world, has a lot of metropolitan area, and the European Union believe that the future, that these areas will determine the future of economical, social, and territorial development of the European Union, because they are the engine of the economy, place of connectivity, creativity, and innovation, and most important thing, center of service for the surrounding areas, for the areas of the metropolitan city. So, we have to face some problems, less unemployment, such as unemployment, segregation, and poverty, also in Europe. But thriving and dynamic metropolitan city can play an important role in the well-being, facing and resolving this problem. In other words, we can say that metropolitan city, metropolitan area, are both the problem and the solution of the problem. Let me give you one example that I have to face in school building plan in our city. Steel shipping container, as you know, are often considered the waste after a trip by ship, you know, waste to be recycled. And this is a problem in some countries. For example, in India, we have thousands and thousands of unused shipping container, unused shipping container. But in Mumbai, some innovative architect planned a skyscraper to regenerate a slum made by shipping container. And this is a solution of a problem in an innovative way. And there was an international competition that stimulated architects to build buildings, low-cost building, using shipping container. And then I was searching on the web for I am responsible for the school buildings of the metropolitan area, 160 school buildings. I'm searching for the most innovative buildings in Europe. And I found that one of the most innovative buildings in Europe is made by used shipping container in Amsterdam. It is a very beautiful and fantastic building made by shipping containers. And now in New York, there are plans to make a luxury house made by used shipping container. In this case, I can say that a problem can be an innovative solution. So in Italy, we have, in this moment, 10 metropolitan cities. They cover the 30% of the population and 11% of the surface of the area. The numbers are different compared to the world because we have a difference. We have 8,000 municipalities in Italy. So the small municipalities are an important reality, not only for the economic, but also for the social context. In the third country, the numbers are different. And we produce the 20% of the services for the population and a third of the national, the GDP. Okay. The metropolitan city of Torino replaced the province of Turin in 2015 and is composed by the Torino city and 314 municipalities. Maybe the number of the provincial council of Barcelona, about 300, more than 300. It's very big, the biggest metropolitan city in Italy, and is located in the northwest of Italy. Some data, 315 municipality, 2,250,000 inhabitants, and as I told before, more than 50% of the area is mountainous area. This is an issue for us, for the transport, for example, and not only, 50% of the mountainous area. Main economic sectors, industry, ICT, business service, tourism, agriculture. The governance in Italy of the metropolitan city is made by the metropolitan mayor, that is the mayor of the city of Turin, elected by the citizen of Turin. The metropolitan council is composed by members elected by mayors and councillors of the municipalities, of the 315 municipalities, and the metropolitan conference is composed by all the mayors of the metropolitan area. So in our case, 315 mayors. One overview about our history, because it's important for the future. It is a connection between the past and the future of our city and our region. Torino was famous in the world, I think, for the Fiat automotive, the most important industrial city in Italy, one of the most important industrial city in Europe. And this is, for example, the industrial area of Mirafiori in Torino, where more than 50,000 workers were employed in 1970, for example. It was important, the most important reality in Italy. And for this reason, after the Second World War, Torino was one of the main actors of the so-called Italian economical miracle, and its population increased, reaching 1.2 million inhabitants, thanks to Fiat Automotive, attracting workers from all over Italy, in particular from the south of Italy. But the imagine of Turin in Italy was Turin is seen as a grey industrial city. This is the image in the past years. What happened in the last 20 years is economic crisis in Italy, in Europe, in the world, in particular in the industrial sectors. And for this reason, we have to rethink totally our perspective, our economic activities, our social context. And for example, this building, in this picture, is one of the buildings where once we built car, and now we built engineer, because it's one of the most important centers of research that hosts the degree courses of industrial design, visual communication, and automotive engineering. So where we have we had 100,000 workers, now we had 100,000 university students. This was the challenge, and this is the challenge for the future. So to do to have a strategy, we define a strategic plan. As you can see in this picture, we have a metropolitan strategic plan that each metropolitan area has to define in 2016. They have been implemented in 2015, so we have to define the strategic plan. In reality, the city of Torino has a strategic plan since 20 years ago. So the challenge was to extend the strategic plan of the city of Torino to metropolitan area. This is one of the challenge of this year and the last year. We have different actions, as you can see, new model of governance, fostering attractiveness and competitiveness of and innovation of our territory, promote social cohesion and inclusion, balancing the relationship between rural and urban areas. That is one of the most important goal of our strategic plan, the sustainable use of natural resources, the promotion of tourism and cultural heritage, and mobility management. First of all, to reach this goal, we have to design our metropolitan area in so-called homogeneous zone. We defined 11 homogeneous area in which there are a group of municipalities with a very active and participate model of government, of governance, sorry. The involvement of this territory is important to establish a new participatory model for local administration, because at the base of this local homogeneous zone, we have common principles. First of all, the access to resources and service must be guaranteed equally to all the municipality of our metropolitan area. So this is an issue, because we have very small municipality in mountainous area and have to have the same services than the city of Torino. And this is a problem. Specificity and diversity of this homogeneous zone are value, not problem, and this is another issue for us. And then each area will have to recognize the identity, but have to define the role in the development of the all the metropolitan area. Just an overview about what we have in our metropolitan area. This probably is an image that all of you know. This is the city of Torino with the River Po, the Mole. But in our metropolitan area, I have a lot of small rural villages with other kind of problem. We have the highest municipality of Italy, Sestriere, that is an important ski area, one of the most important ski area in Europe. It is part of the metropolitan area. We have a lot of local tradition. This is the orange battle in the Carnival of Ivrea, for example, a city 50 kilometers far from Torino. And yeah, we have, for example, national park like Gran Paradiso, the most important park in Italy. So we have to put all these things in a common strategy by means of our strategic plan. And this is very, very difficult. How much time I have?
You have up to 57, you have 15 minutes.
Perfect. Okay. So I'm going to show you some of our project and activities. Some of these activities, as the leader of some of these activities is the city of Torino, the other we are the metropolitan city or the province of Turin, of course. And all this project has a common goal in the strategic plan. For example, we have project about food. This is quite time for lunch, sorry. Food, sport, promotion of sport, preservation of land, cultural heritage, school buildings, and so on. Just an overview. We can start by the territorial coordination plan. The territorial coordination plan covers a regulation on the land usage on the territory of our region and establish the rules for the development of urban areas and rural areas. And is one of the function of the province of Turin and now of the metropolitan city of Turin. So, for example, we noticed that in the last we mapped the data about the land usage in our territory. In the last 5 years, from since 2006, we noticed that the speed of construction in our metropolitan area was three times than in the past. This was a problem that we face introducing in our territorial plan strictly rules for the urbanization in a new area. For example, we define and mapped our territory in three categories: dense area, transition area, and free areas, for example. And we establish what you can do in dense area, in transition area, and free areas. And this was a rule that all the municipalities have to respect in the local plan. It's one not, the municipalities are not very pleased in the first time when we introduced this rule. But after a discussion of some years, they accepted this rule. And for example, each municipality has mapped with the urban area, transition area, and free areas. In the free areas, it's practically not possible to build anything apart from public activities if it's impossible to built them in other area, for example. But it's not available for new buildings, for new activity, or new commercial activity. The transitional area are important because as the element of connection between different urban areas, and so have some rules, but the results of this this policy is very important because we don't have the charts, the new charts, but we stopped in the growth of the land usage in our territory in the last year. So this is one of our activity. Smart City. Smart City is a project of the city of Torino that involved many municipalities, many associations, many agencies. And what is the aim of this project? To transform city in one of the most innovative city in Europe. And we won the prize of the second prize of in the European Capital of Innovation in 2006. The first one was Amsterdam. Okay, but it's a good result. What is SMART? The first step in the last years was a project called TAPE that has five priority areas for implementation: public and private buildings, mobility and transport, energy efficiency, good practices, and renewable energy. And by means of this project, in these years, we get important results, indicators at the end of the process. For example, we have a district heating that served more than 60% of our city, 600,000 inhabitants as district heating and cogeneration, for example. And this can produce a significant reduction of CO2. Ah, okay, it's done. So the same action in the urban sustainable mobility plan and the renovation of buildings. The second step of the last year was to go from a project called TAPE at a project called SMILE. What is the difference? The difference was that we have introduced a new field of action from mobility and energy that was in the first project, inclusion, life, and health. So we have four vertical domains and a different priority objective. Some data, probably indicators of the process, as you can see. 350 people involved in this project with 28 companies, 23 entities, Center of Research, Association. Five thematic work group. The involvement of all the departments of the municipality, all the departments. 77 people involved only of the municipality of Turin, and 10,000 man hours spent in this project. This because, as I told before, we have 100,000 university students in our city, and we believe that this is an enormous potential for our city for the development of innovative strategy and innovative project. Some of the results of the project submitted, project in incubation phase, and project funded by means SMILE project. One of the action is energy saving at school. As you probably know, the problem of school building in Italy, I don't know, in other countries, I think it's the same, is that the 95% of buildings are existing building. New building, the construction of new school building is very, very low in Italy. And the 70% of school buildings has more than 30 years. And this is a problem because we have to face different problems compared to a new construction in which it's very easy to improve all the performance, energy performance of the building. 5 minutes, okay. For this reason, we implemented a project in which we involved directly the school, the teacher, and the student in the improvement of the performance of the school buildings. Because we believe that the school building is one of the teacher of the students, the third teacher, because there are the teacher, the other children, and the physical environment in which we live. For this reason, we have a research project with the Polytechnic of Torino called Green School, in which we develop an innovative approach with the management of the buildings of the metropolitan city of Torino, facilitating the transformation of existing school building in sustainable school buildings. So in these three, you can see why we change our approach in the energy saving in school building, because we work on different, together with the student and together with the teacher, to in different field of action, for example, in transport, facilitating and stimulating student to go by walk at school or by bicycle, in the waste, in the right use of lighting in the classroom, for example, turn off the light when you go get out the room. Simple actions, but with the direct involvement of students. And so we have an evaluation of the, and a certification of the green quality of buildings made by not only the performance, energy performance, but also environment performance, social performance, economic performance, functional performance, and process quality in our building. This because we believe that high-performing schools results in high-performing students, and green schools so can give us an opportunity to educate a new generation of students, leaders, capable of driving the transformation in our reality. And last, it's time to lunch. We have to talk about our typical product, because in the last years, create a brand called Prodotti del Paniere, literally basket of typical products of the province of Turin, or now the metropolitan city of Turin. This is another project in which we guarantee and protect typical food of the area. But the base of this project is to protect, preserve, and promote only traditional product produced by traditional by local manufacturers with traditional methods and with local ingredients. And transform so this cultural heritage of our territory in an opportunity for the development of these rural areas. And in this project, we involved, we defined 32 protect brand and dock wines, 900 local producer, 30 shops and 60 restaurants that participate in the promotion and use only our product. This because, as you probably know, Torino hosts every year Salone del Gusto, Terra Madre, in which 5,000 delegates from 160 countries this big community will take part in the most important international event dedicated to food culture in our territory. So, I finished? Perfect, yes. In time? Yeah. It's not Italian to be perfect in time. For example, just one last conclusion. Each project that I presented can be a positive fallout in each of the voices of our strategic plan. And this is important because, for example, the protection of typical food is a project that starts from the promotion of tourism and cultural heritage, but has, of course, a positive impact on the balancing the relationship between rural and urban areas, on the sustainable use of natural resource, on fostering attractiveness and competitiveness of our territory, and so on. And this is possible for each of the projects I presented. Okay. Thank you very much for your attention. Thank you.